Hey guys. Hey guys.
Now what's going on, y'all? What's up, y'all? Kevin Artonius here. Thanks for watching ReAnimix Reviews, where we give the best indie reviews on the planet. Doing something different today. I guess you could call this a vlog, so to speak. Just kind of wanted to go into an event that I went to last night called Thinking Out the Box, Why Technology Matters in Hip Hop. It's hosted by the Underground Collective and the Beats and Bars Festival 2018. Thinking Out the Box, Crystal Taylor and John Law. It's kind of a forum setting. Had three panelists, one Shaka T, two is Dr. Eric Saleem, three is J-Mac, producer. Let me give a quick introduction to these three panelists. Shaka T is the owner, he doesn't work there, he's the owner, he's a brother, he's the owner of Playground Studios. Playground Studios is an official, when I say official, I do mean official. It's a recording studio. It has a staging area. It has a photography area. It's like a one-stop shop. You know, it has, like, when I say recording studio, I mean like the official types that you might see on TV. You know, with the full mixer, the huge mixer that you see, all the speakers, the right speakers, the sound booths where you can actually see into the other room through plexiglass. Actually, there are two sound booths, there are two recording studios, and then on the other side, because it's a commercial space, so it's a huge commercial space that he's using, and on the other side of the space, there is like rooms for artists to kind of just rent out to just create, you know. You can rent out this room, this space where you can bring whatever you want to bring, and that just be your space where you can create and do whatever you need to do. So it has full bells and whistles. It's a great place to go. The prices are economical for what it offers. You know, ain't gonna be 40 an hour, but it's definitely, for what you're getting, it's a great price, you know, because you're getting top of the line service. So definitely check out Playground Studios and Shaka T for sure. Great brother. Known him for a little bit, and you know, he's helped me with the Digital Brilliance Hour when the kids needed a place to record their album. You know, that's where we went. We went there in Bull City Studios, and they loved going to his spot. They loved the environment. They loved just everything about it, and I appreciate him for even allowing us to come there, you know, because, you know, when the teens went, they were a lot more well-behaved because they had a mission, you know, and they were in tune with what they were doing. But when I had the middle school, you know, required a little bit more patience with them, and I'm glad that, you know, he had that patience. So, yeah, Shaka T, Playground Studios. Next person, Dr. Eric Saleem. He runs a program. He's actually a professor at North Carolina Central University in the biology department. But he also runs an initiative program called Fab Lab, which was influenced by a trip that he had to MIT and things that they were doing there, where they were building creations for profit, basically. In his idea, though, I mean, in the same instance, it does provide that space, but also, you know, it's open to the public, although it's on a college campus. It's a huge facility, you know, and it has so many different tools that you could have access to. It has a 3D scanner, a 3D printer, coding area, robotics. Like, it has so many different things, so many different tools that you can use. Like, if you just had this out of the box idea, like just out of the blue, and really didn't know how to go about building it, but this idea stuck with you, this would be the place for you. Like, if you were driven, personally driven, to figure out a way to make this work, but you're like, man, but I don't, you know, I need this, but I don't have it. You know, I would love to be able to do this, but I don't have this tool. This would be the, like, this place was created just for that. You know, they're already making money, bringing it back into the program. They have quite a few products. Like, for example, you know, let's say you were a person who wanted to think up a program or an app that provided something very useful for a lot of people. You know, you go to the Fab Lab, you know, you collaborate with people who have the same intentions of creating and having that drive to learn. And with the information being there, you're able to create something. And then you find someone who would love to have that idea and take it to the next level. There have been investors who have paid for those services, paid for those tools. In one end, they kind of just bought out the IP outright, or they have made residual income from the profits that the other companies have made on the tool that they built. So, you know, it's such a great program. And they're also active in the community. They provide robotics classes and robotic tournaments for kids and schools. They go out, you know, outreach. You know, they're really trying to enforce the idea that technology really does matter. Science and math really does matter. I'm a software engineer, so this is right up my alley. I'm a scientist. So the things that they do is so great, so great. And then the last but not least, Jay Mack. I've known him for a little bit, and he's worked with so many. I'm not one to name drop when it comes to who people work with. If you want to know more about who he's worked with, just, you know, hit him up and go to his site. But I'm just going to say, you know, he's official, dude. Just being real, man. He's won awards as high as, like, Red Bull championships. And, you know, he's had songs that, like, are literally viral songs. When I say viral, like, on commercials, like TV commercials, just think of A Great Day. Gotta get going, tomorrow's not promised, so I live in the moment. It's a good day to have a good day. It's a good day. You know what I'm saying? Think of that song. That song, A Great Day. I didn't even know he made that. Like, that was a song that him and this other brother just decided to create just for creation's sake, and it became this huge success. You know, it's being used everywhere. And I didn't even know he created that. You know what I'm saying? I just found that out last night. The connections that he has with around the country and around the world is astronomical for someone who's just so down to earth. He's a down to earth individual. And, you know, his knowledge of engineering and production is very high. You know, he started at a low spot, got that respect from Ninth Wonder, like, literal respect. Like, he actually talked to him, and Ninth Wonder gave him the confidence to keep going, and, you know, that's all it really took. So that's J-Mac. I know I gave lengthy introductions, but I think they deserved it. But as far as the program went, it was a great program. Like, it was all about creativity from a technological mindset. There were a lot of great questions. There was a question about AR and VR in hip-hop, and I thought it was a great question because it made me think up an idea, because I'm a visionary and I don't mind giving out ideas, because you can't copy me. You can copy my ideas, but you can't copy me. Your greatness only goes as far as the idea you steal from me. I'm going to leave it at that. People who know about that story know who it's going to. But anyway, AR, VR music video, you know, because AR, VR is really on the rise. Just think about the idea of having a music video that's actually geared towards those VR glasses that could come with mobile or the Vive, and it just gives this whole brand new experience for your videos. You know, somebody need to get on it. I ain't got time, because again, I think I'm one of those dudes, you know, where I can't give a 5-second elevator pitch of what I do, because I do so much. I'm always thinking of things to do. I was one of them kids that couldn't sit still because I always needed something to do. You know, I'm thinking of how to improve things, like, all the time. I'm a scientist. So somebody else, man, hopefully somebody takes this idea and actually creates. And if you do, please let me know. You know, send me an email to epskevin@gmail.com or reanimixtv@gmail.com. My Facebook, Instagram, ReAnimix TV. So yeah, definitely let me know if you do that, because I'd be happy to push that initiative as much as I can and help support it. Another thing, there were a lot of engineers there. There were people there, like there's this brother who was a photographer, but he was actually a software engineer first. I didn't even know that, you know. So we linked up, try to build more on that aspect. And, you know, audio engineers, just people who think from a different perspective than, oh, I just like to perform and make music. You know, it's more to it than that. And that's kind of what they touched on, is how you're going to make that music relatable to the public. You know, because production isn't just, oh, I just created this 5-beat. Oh, I made these hot lyrics and everything just work out. No, man. Like, you got to engineer it in a way that people can feel the music. Like, you know, we're engineering with the frequency spectrum. You got the low end area. That's where you feel, like, you feel the low end. Like, that's why there's so much bass. That's why people are dancing so much, because they figured out the formula when it comes to these newer songs, because they got all these low bass hits, you know, that's hitting really low, and everybody dancing, everybody talking about the beat, you know, in the club. That's why they play the big bassy stuff in the club, because you feel the bass, you feel it. Then the mid-range, you hear that. And the high end controls how you perceive it. Perceive and hear everything, you know. So you feel it, you got the perception in it, and all of that is science, you know. I know I sound nerdy, but shit, I don't care. All that really matters in production. And when you have an executive producer who sees all those hats, you know, they understand that matters. That's why you have those different people. You got the artist, you got the producer, you have the engineer, you have, like, if you're going on the road, you got the sound guy, you got the videographer, you got your photographer, you got the visual editor. You have so many different types of jobs that are in relation to an artist, you know. So and you have someone at the top who actually oversees all of that to make sure they run cohesively. So all of that matters. So this event was just very great at explaining all of that. And then also, I think either Crystal or J-Mac might have brought this up on how, you know, how music plays a role and hip-hop plays a role in video games. Like, you know, most people don't always talk about that kind of stuff. And, you know, I just found it refreshing to hear other people other than myself talk about this stuff. I don't really talk about it online, but, you know, that's definitely a topic of conversation. Well, hell, I have ReAnimix TV. That's like the epitome of applying music to different situations. I'm applying hip-hop music and your submitted music to anime. You know, that's a different take on, I mean, yes, it's a re-engineered anime show. It's not like an AMV where you just slap some music and you got a video playing above it. No, it's like you're taking the show, you're re-engineering it where the sound effects and the vocals are still on the top, but below it you have different types of music that you guys submit in. So that's the epitome of what I already do. So this type of event was just perfect, you know. And I really do commend the Underground Collective for starting this Thinking Out the Box initiative. They're going to have this event every month. I said once a month, I believe. And you guys really do need to follow the Underground Collective to stay up to date, especially if you're in the Raleigh-Durham area, if in the Triangle area. The music community can make you feel like, and I'm just being real right now, it can make you feel as if being a nerd is unacceptable, or it's white. And I could go on a long rant about that, but I'm not. But anyway, but it's not white, because I'm, again, hashtag dark skin problem. So, like, I I'm not white, and I've been this way ever since I can remember. I wanted to be a scientist when I was 7, when I was living in the hood. And when I say hood, I mean real hood, like McDougal's Terrace type hood. And I was in that space and in that environment, and I was still thinking about being a scientist. So that's just saying. So that's in me through and through. A lot of people feel that way. It's great to have this space for those people, because science, math, technology does matter. And we don't, you know, the average listener doesn't always get that. We just look at what the TV shows us in the limelight and assume that that's all that matters, and it's not, you know. And this initiative allows us to think of different ways to understand that philosophy and know that what gets presented to us isn't always the full truth, and that might lead to other discussions. Yeah, I know this is getting kind of long, and I'm sorry, but I really did have a great time. You know, just stuff that's kind of been on my heart for a long time, and I think that this has sparked all those feelings that I've had for such a long time, which is why this is such a long video. But yeah, make sure to follow Underground Collective. Make sure to follow J-Mac, the producer. Make sure to follow and look into Fab Lab at North Carolina Central University, nccu.edu. And make sure to go to playgroundstudios.com. And yeah, man, just schedule a tour, man. Just if you're in the area, just go schedule a tour, man. Go look at what they have to offer, man. Like, it'll inspire you so much. Just check them out, man. It's owned by a brother, you know. And there's another studio called Bull City Sound Studios, and they have a great studio as well. Check both of them out, man. Just schedule a tour. You know, you don't have to buy anything at the moment, but shoot, once you go into those spaces, you might end up doing more business than you thought you were going to do when you get there. I'm trying to tell you, because there's so much that they offer. Check all of that out. Don't forget to keep up with the channel, ReAnimix Reviews. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. I probably won't do these all the time, but I just felt the need to speak on this subject because that spoke more to my core a little bit more. Make sure you click the bell, because I don't have time to always remind people what to do. I mean, when you doing so much, you just ain't got time to do all that. Also, just to say one more thing before I go, this kind of environment, you know, that whole 7 to 9 p.m. during the week or 12 p.m. during the week, anything that's before 9 p.m. during the week, oh man, yeah, that's more my speed, man. That whole 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. and that 2 a.m. mess, like, that ain't me, man. That ain't me no more, man. 38 now, like, at 21 I was doing that, but now, shoot, man, it's a totally different life. 38 now, I have two dependents, and they're adult dependents. You got my mother and mother-in-law. And let me tell you, man, dealing with adult dependents, totally different ball game than working with kids. With kids, you know that they're inexperienced. You could be a lot more patient with them, although they might try to work in there, but they kids. I mean, yeah, like, you can control their environment enough to ensure that it doesn't affect you as much. But with an adult, though, like, their actions could lead to issues so much larger than a kid can, and an issue that you have to, like, stop your life to tend to if you're not being proactive and making sure that they are sticking within the lines that they need to stick in, because they're not at the same spot that they used to be when they were the providers and independent, you know. And they've been that for so long, you have that tit for tat, like, all the time. And yeah, all of that gets kind of draining too, but I mean, you love them, man. It's not nothing to make you want to go away and stop doing it. So I had that going on. So these type of events where you just chill and talk, have a little forum, I don't need to be hopped up, I don't need to be doing all that, just want to chill, that is more my speed. I'm hopped up all day at work and all the stuff I do, so when I get somewhere, I just want to chill. And after 9, that's it, man. You know, I get up at 5 a.m. to start the day again. I, you know, got work and many different things that I'm doing. So, you know, my time kind of matters. So, yeah, I just wanted to make sure I stated that, because all the events that happen, I definitely want to make sure that I support them and in any way I can. But I may not always get to come to them because, you know, my life is entirely different than most. But, yeah. Thanks for watching ReAnimix Reviews. Tune in next time. Peace.